Skyblock's new 1.0 update will completely change Skyblock as we know it, bringing new items, balances, and metas. It's a very controversial topic, as many people disagree with the admins and their anticipated ideas for the big update. In today's video, I'll be sharing my personal opinion of Skyblock 1.0, including a look at the pros and cons of the upcoming revamp. If you enjoy the video, consider leaving a like and subscribing. I'd really appreciate it and it helps the channel out a lot. Also, head on over to my Discord. We hold weekly Skyblock giveaways and it's a great place to hang out. See you there. So, what is Skyblock 1.0, you might ask? Well, buckle yourself up because you're in for a ride. Essentially, the staff team plan to rebalance Skyblock entirely by adding tons of new features to every aspect of the game. Sounds complicated, right? Well, yes, that is why you should not panic sell your items, as the update is said to come out in a very long time. There is no set date, but as you know, it takes Hypixel a long time to push out these important updates. So yeah. Just before we get into it, I'd like to talk to you about today's sponsor, Orhunt. Orhunt is like Skyblock, but with tons of unique features. They have one of the most detailed texture packs I've ever seen. The realistic fishing physics are incredible. It's just like real life, except you don't need to go outside and touch grass. Mining becomes even more fun when your pickaxe gains enchants as you mine. Sick of grinding? No problem. Orhunt has its very own AFK system which can be used to upgrade your pickaxes. One of my favourite parts of the server is that it limits pay to win as much as possible, creating an even playing field. So what are you waiting for? Give it a shot at jake.mintr.ee. Make sure to use my IP, it'll be in the description. I hope to see you there. On Hypixel's forums, the admins have slowly released threads on their ideas for the update. The first thread, also known as the introductory thread, basically explains the admins' vision for Skyblock. They talk about how Skyblock is made up of four main aspects: social, creativity, progression, and economy, which you'll see more in the rest of this video. The aim of Skyblock 1.0 is to improve these by using the experience which the staff team have learned in the beta. Players are then able to submit their ideas, which they think will improve these aspects. I thought this was a very good idea, as players are what makes Skyblock what it is today. Without them, Skyblock wouldn't exist. Now onto the more important threads, starting with skills. In this post, the admins gave us an insight into what skills were meant to be for. Believe it or not, skills were not intended to be an important part of the game, but they became one. The original purpose was to unlock new islands early in the game and give small rewards, like coins. Over time, skills gained a lot of attention, which led to the staff team doing total revamps of almost every skill. Mining even received its own upgradable skill tree in the Dwarven Mines update called the Heart of the Mountain. After the success of this update, the admins didn't want to stop there. They plan to add one of these trees for every single skill. That's crazy just to think about, as it will make Skyblock way more fun in terms of grinding. Because of this, skills will have much more meaningful rewards, stats, and perks. The staff team is also aiming to release another farming island called the Garden, which will make the skill farming a lot easier to level up. Another thing to know is that farming sets like Mushroom and Cactus will be given unique abilities to help with progression. Overall, the staff team wants skills to be a much more important aspect of Hypixel Skyblock and progression, leading to a much more enjoyable and full experience. The next thread talks about private islands and levels. There's no doubt that private islands have been neglected ever since Skyblock was released. The admins correctly stated it as a parking place, a place you go before you finish the grind and disconnect. In the 1.0 update, the staff team plans to add new customizations and more ways to upgrade minions. Not only that, but they plan to add small rewards or events that happen when you come back to your private island, one of which includes a dragon fight. These events and minion upgrades will scale progressively depending on your Skyblock level. The admins think that skill average and weight systems are not good for measuring progress or state of the game, as they rely on only a few aspects of Skyblock. Skyblock 1.0 uses a new system called levels, which will ultimately be used as a new way to work out progression in Skyblock. Levels will also be used as requirements to certain features like the bank, accessory bag, and bazaar. There will be EXP given for things like bestiary milestones, leveling up skills, and killing slayer bosses for the first time. This will allow the top players to distinguish who the real top player is, as the bestiary and museum are almost impossible to max out. The top 500 players with the highest level, also known as the Elite 500, will receive a tab tag similar to those of ranks, but much more of a flex. I think that most of these ideas are good, but I'm just hoping that the level system is balanced from the start and doesn't flop on release. Onto the next thread, collection and minions. Collections were originally made so that players could unlock new recipes and slowly work their way through the game. This, however, did not turn out how the admins expected it, as many players could max out their collection very easily. In Skyblock 1.0, we are expected to see collections increase to allow for a slower learning curve. This is mainly because, on unlocking multiple collections at once, players are bombarded with recipes which they often skip over. The collections won't be increased to numbers that are impossible to reach, but instead numbers that provide a slow learning curve experience. The staff team also realized that at the time, when the Pigman Sword was one of the best in the game, it had no usage requirements and could easily be crafted using materials from minions. In the future, late game items will require late game drops, which cannot be gained by early game players. I think this is a good idea, as it will improve Skyblock's aspect of progression quite a lot. There are many problems with minions, you might disagree, but this comes straight from the admins. They believe that minions give too much skill XP, are too fast, and compete with manual collecting. Despite a couple of these things being debatable, the admins have noticed these flaws and plan to improve them in the 1.0 update. We know that there are good and bad minions, it's the reason why you'd use a snow minion over an oakwood minion. This will soon change, as NPC sell prices will completely be revamped to make minions less competitive. Also, according to the admins, minions were never meant to give as much XP as they do now. It was originally intended to help level up those boring skills which no one likes. Skills are slowly being revamped, resulting in the staff team concluding that minion XP should be nerfed. In my opinion, I'm not a fan of this change, but I think it's a good way to encourage players to grind XP rather than get it from minions. You've probably used minions for collections at some point because you just can't compete with the minion's efficiency. This is why the staff team want to increase the speed at which players can gain materials rather than heavily nerf minions. There are a lot of changes being done to collections and minions in the Skyblock 1.0 update, but I believe it's for the better of the game. The next thread talks about playing alone and playing together. In Skyblock 1.0, Hypixel plans to make the game a more solo experience, where players coexist rather than rely on others. If you've ever grinded Zealots, you know it can be a very toxic experience, especially around late game or end game players. The admins want to reduce the toxicity of this gameplay by adding in systems that allow you to loot share in the entirety of Skyblock. Loot share works by sharing your drop from the mob to the players around you in a certain block radius. Boss loot from dragons comes down to whether you have higher damage than other players, causing lobbies to be identified as good or bad. The staff team have noticed this and have decided to stop your loot from being affected by another player's performance. You won't need to worry about people dealing tens of millions of damage to dragons, as your loot will depend on your solo performance. Hypixel also intends to implement a matchmaking system for public islands. Weird, right? Well, it isn't actually as bad as it sounds. Let me explain. Public island matchmaking will match players based on their estimated strength when they join the island. The system won't be perfect, but it will help new players as they won't need to compete for scraps. Players will be able to play in the same lobbies as their friends, no matter their progression. Matchmaking just makes it easier to communicate with other players since they'll be in a similar stage of game to you. There's also been some talk between the staff team about adding guild islands. In the end, they decided on adding guild houses in the hub. I think that this would be a very beneficial feature as guilds can interact a lot more, although it may cause arguments. Overall, these new feature ideas sound great, but I wonder how they can make dragon fights fair, as some can go really fast and you might not be able to get much damage. Therefore, your loot is dependent on other players. After powering through a lot of large ideas the admins have for the game, they decided to make the following post about a few of their smaller ideas. When I say a few, I don't really mean a few, I mean a lot. They've just announced huge changes for dungeons, which include the fact that only 60% of secrets will need to be found to get the maximum score. To compensate, the speed score will be harder to max out based on each floor's average speed. To encourage daily dungeon grinding, the first 5 runs in a day will grant 40% more EXP. You'll also be granted the first completion EXP bonus for your first 5 completions of a certain floor. We all know that the dungeon queue has never been that great, and Hypixel intends to change this by adding automatic matchmaking. This will make it super easy to find parties that are to your standards. I'm really looking forward to these changes, as they'll be very beneficial to dungeons, as it will encourage early game players to try it out. The admins believe that collecting fairy souls should not be mandatory, as it takes a lot of time and gives too much of a stat buff. In the 1.0 update, fairy souls will plan to unlock extra storage space or to provide more level XP instead of health, strength, defense, and speed. In my opinion, this is a hard but right decision the staff team have made, as when studying a profile, fairy souls are essential and can take hours to collect. I hope they can find more ways to encourage players to get fairy souls, as extra storage space doesn't sound that exciting. There will also be a huge quest revamp, as the admins want to make it a lot easier for players to discover the world of Skyblock and figure out its story. Not only that, but as mentioned before at the start of the video, there will be a ton of balancing being done to weapons and gear in the preparation for 1.0's release. Believe it or not, the staff team love the idea of exotics, which is why they're creating an alternate way to die armor without ruining the value of exotics. The way this will work is that there will be a very rare colored die dropped from only a selected amount of mobs. Once applied to leather armor, the armor set will display the color, but also have a new icon in its description. I think this is quite cool, as exotics are very expensive and hard to come by. The armor dice will still cost quite a lot, as they will become some sort of RNG drop from mobs, but are likely to be substantially cheaper than exotics due to the icon in the descriptions. Finally, the museum. This newly released building will most certainly cause inflation due to many players wanting to fill it up as fast as possible. There will also be a leaderboard in the middle of it, which players can flex their net worth on. Overall, I believe these small changes combined will make Skyblock a much more enjoyable and polished game. This next thread has caused some of the most debates, as its main ideas revolve around damage. During Skyblock 1.0, 4 new armor slots will be added. They will consist of cloaks, gauntlets, belts, and necklaces. Another small but very exciting announcement has been made that the new best armor set in the game will come out in the Nether update. The Nether update alone never sounded that good until I heard this, as a new armor set usually means a new boss. For some reason, the admins believe that health is a more interesting and more important stat than defense. They want to make it so gear, weapons, and reforges will provide much less defense and a lot more health. Luckily, healing items will be buffed to accommodate for these changes. We'll finally see nerfs to One For All, as the staff team make room for a lot of new offensive and defensive enchants. So far, you'll only be allowed to play a limited amount of enchants on your gear. The accessory bag is known for how overpowered it can be when maxed out. You've probably reforged a talisman, only to change it again when another meta comes out. Well, don't worry about spending millions of coins again, because in Skyblock 1.0, once you've reforged a talisman to a certain reforge, you'll be able to swap between it for free. I think that this feature will be awesome to have, because it improves Skyblock's quality of life a ton. The next topic in gear modifiers is what sparked many disagreements between the admins and the players of Skyblock. The essence system has given us the ability to start all dungeon items and a decent amount of overworld items. The staff team want to stretch this out a bit more, allowing players to start almost every tool and armor piece in Skyblock, but stars will work very differently. Items that can only be found in dungeons will have stars that only work in dungeons, vice versa for the overworld. A lot of players are unhappy about these ideas, as the main archer class's weapons, the Juju and Terminator, are overworld items. This will leave archers useless, as there aren't many good dungeon bows besides bone rings, which are heavily nerfed. A lot of players didn't like this change, so hopefully it will never be implemented into the game. Another big change for Skyblock is that almost every item will be downscaled by one rarity. The admin's reasoning for this is that rarities like legendary should be reserved for good, not average items. There are quite a few ideas that could be changed, but overall, I am very impressed with what the Hypixel staff team has to offer, and I look forward to the Skyblock 1.0 update. That's all for today, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, consider leaving a like and subscribing. Thanks again to Orhunt for sponsoring this video. Go check them out at jake.mindtr.ee. Thanks for watching, see ya!